I started painting in high school. I painted and wanted to be a cartoonist before I sang, but it became something that I would do when I couldn't fit something into a song. And the golden age of Grotesque became, for me, not just an album, but an era of expressionism. Thus, my choice of coming to Berlin, which is the birthplace of that art movement, and working with Gottfried Helnwein is a great inspiration. But these pieces are all things that I created kind of between the period of 1995 to now. Unfortunately, I couldn't bring all of them. This is just a few of the ones that are left because a lot of them are in people's homes now, which was kind of sad, but I had to learn to deal with as a painter. I started painting in high school. I painted and wanted to be a cartoonist before I sang, but it became something that I would do when I couldn't fit something into a song. And the golden age of Grotesque became, for me, not just an album, but an era of expressionism. Thus, my choice of coming to Berlin, which is the birthplace of that art movement, and working with Gottfried Helnwein is a great inspiration. But these pieces are all things that I created kind of between the period of 1995 to now. Unfortunately, I couldn't bring all of them. This is just a few of the ones that are left because a lot of them are in people's homes now, which was kind of sad, but I had to learn to deal with as a painter. My favorite painters were Salvador Dali and Egon Schiele and Gottfried Helnwein, which I got to work with. So as far as my color schemes and things like that, I use a children's watercolor set. So it has a lot of pastels and very pleasant colors, so when I paint other things that are more grotesque, then it has a greater contrast. Well, I think that you can take a term like grotesque or degenerate, degenerative, and you can have it not be derogatory by realizing that if something's degenerative, it breaks down walls and things like that. So for me on this album and this whole approach with installations and action movements in the show, it's about breaking down the borders that I've already established for myself, not even just the ones that the world has made. So I also had to reinvent myself for my own ability to exist and my own boredom, to not come to an end of creativity. I asserted myself as a scapegoat with Antichrist Superstar, but burlesque, vaudeville, cabaret, all these things were great escapes from the world when the world was at war, times of fear. The city of Berlin is a perfect place for this to be an example. And now America being at war, the most patriotic thing I can do is to be an artist and to fight for freedom of expression. So a lot of the images that are in the other room that I did with Gottfried Helnwein, some of them were forbidden. The Mickey Mouse images, the image of the girl and the child. So if someone tells me I can't put it in my record, then I put it here for everyone to see. So it's about disregarding the boundaries that are set forth in music, because you can't limit your entire expression just to a CD when you can have all this, because now everybody who's here is also a part of the whole experience, and that makes the art complete. Well, painting is something I've always done when I couldn't express it into music, but now everything kind of goes hand in hand. So a lot of the songs that were written for this album were inspired by images. I would wake up and say, I want a song that is a burning piano, or I want a song that is a Busby Berkeley chorus line of girls, or a stampeding elephant and things like that. So I started to work around mediums and not really differentiate any from each other, and or fiction from reality for that matter. Well, whatever I create is my way of explaining or defending myself, but I would never defend or explain what I do. And seeing how I've established that I would die for what I create, I can't live without it either. So art is what makes me happy, if anything does. It's my way of making life worth living. And the fact that I could share it with other people makes it even better. This painting I did at the same time when I wrote an essay for Rolling Stone magazine, because everybody wanted me to respond to all of the allegations with Columbine and just about entertainment and violence. And everything that I've always represented has been a statement against that. To begin with, Marilyn Manson itself is pointing out the flaws of how the media handled Columbine, that they created their own problem. And I painted this at the same time that I wrote the essay, and it's sort of a tribute or a parody to the original poster for the movie MASH, which the peace sign, which actually originally meant victory, which has been forgotten, but it again becomes more appropriate now that we're at war, because I think while neither of these two people were heroes, they did represent the flaws in American society, and it's important for me to always point that out, to make people reconsider what they believe in and make sure that their values are strong enough in that thing that I did of him. So it also has, again, a very faded American imagery in the background with a black and white flag. What I thought that I'd like to look like when I get old, if I live that long, and I actually painted a lot of this with absinthe.
While drinking it?
Because I accidentally dipped my brush in the wrong glass, so I figured I'd just use it anyways. And so a lot of this green is absinthe. Well, I think the important thing